Jacques Hetu is at a crossroads in his life. He's just retired from a long career teaching music. For the first time in his life, he can do nothing but compose. He's just finished a concerto for organ and orchestra, and he's already thinking about another. It'll probably be a triple concerto for piano, violin, and cello. Beyond that, the waiting list extends to 12 commissions, several years' worth. Hetu is one of Canada's most successful composers. Yet there was a time when he was a prophet without honor in his own land, when he wasn't modern enough for Quebec's critical establishment. I caught up with Jacques Hetu at his home on a wooded hillside near the town of Saint-Hippolyte, an hour north of Montreal.
It was a farm here. My wife was making goat cheese with 40 goats. But it was 25 years ago, you know.
We walk the property to the edge of the woods. We're surrounded by rolling hills. A gleaming lake stretches off in the distance. There are splashes of color everywhere, the first hints of fall.
He has many, you know, gardens and flowers.
We arrive at a screened-in porch attached to the guest house. There's a smell of fresh paint.
Construction here.
We're getting close to the house now. It's a two-story chalet. It's been updated and added onto, but still has a real Laurentian charm. I can see Etu's wife in a south-facing window, fussing over some plants.
Hello?
Good morning, how are you?
Fine, and you?
Sorry, I'm just...
Books, armchairs, varnished wood everywhere. The house is airy, cheerful, and comfortable. We climb the stairs to Etu's studio. He walks over to a drafting table set up in the middle of the room. Behind him is the piano. He opens a large manuscript book and shows me his latest triumph, a concerto for organ and symphony orchestra. The ink's barely dry. The concerto will be the first music played on the brand new organ in Edmonton's Windspear Center.
I had to put an orchestral density, you know, because I'm sure that there will be no problem for the organ. But the balance, you know. So maybe it's the first work that I will be obliged to change some dynamics. Uh-huh. Because never change a note of my music. Maybe some phrasing, yes, just little things. But I've never changed a note of an orchestral or soloist part. But the organ, you know, with this work, I don't know.
That note of uncertainty comes as something of a surprise, because Etu's famous for delivering a well-thought-through score. Maybe it's because for the very first time he's not composing for a specific performer. That person hasn't been hired yet. What's more, nobody's heard the organ. It hasn't even been built. While I look through the score, Etu pulls out a fat pipe, lights it, and takes a drag. For his old friend, conductor Mario Bernardi, it's a cherished gesture.
Oh, he looks very mild. Should I say typical French-Canadian? I mean, he's but maybe not so typical, because he seems to have an aura of Europe about him. He has a very charming wife. I speak French, so I'm very much at ease with him. He does have a stinking bloody pipe. And if you can forgo that, he's a very charming man, very mild-mannered, jovial, really, in his outlook to life, it seems to me.